Check, check, 1, 2. Is this on even?
Am I on?
Are we on?
Oh.
Whoa. Hey!
I was whispering. I didn't realize that,
I'm like really low on this picture too. That we are good to go.
Yeah, Rodney I can hear myself talking.
Can you? Oh, yeah.
I didn't realize that you had like...
We're...
Sorry, I'm freezing.
We're getting down. We're going down and getting down.
Downtown to Brown.
Alrighty.
Hey, remember you gotta talk quietly. That way my mic doesn't pick you up.
I've gotta talk quietly. In a low, sultry voice. Sultry.
This is an ASMR stream.
Yeah. Thank you all for coming in on short notice.
Hi, Dodge. Liz and that other guy in the house, basically.
The other dude. Playing a dude.
The other dude.
What is going on? The camera's like... just twisted a little bit.
You're twisted a little bit.
So how's everyone doing? Sad news this last month with the passing of Ed. That was crazy. So, I watched, I don't know how many of you watched The Bird's Nest and or Reaper Live. Super touching shows. Both really good. And yeah, we're going to miss Ed. He was a big part of the Reaper Vex, actually. That was like, he was really excited to get that. So anyways, yeah. We're going to miss him.
Agreed.
All right. Well, let's get on to painting. I don't know how else to do that.
There's no good transition between being sad.
There. But you know what? Ed would be painting. So you know what?
You're right.
Bam, that's what we're going to do. Right. I don't have any palette paper. So I'll be right back. And you guys enjoy Liz here.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Uh-huh. Hi.
I was pretty prepared tonight. I swear to God. It's just...
No. It's been a day. I have a migraine. I still have a migraine. So we are doing the best that we can tonight. How is everyone? Sexy Aaron tonight. Yep. That's what he's... Oh my God, you can see how messy his desk is. Please don't look.
Hey.
It wouldn't be a show without Aaron forgetting something.
Oh, don't be looking at my desk.
So
how dare you? It's like peeking at my undies or something.
Yeah,
I'm not. Listen, it's like peeking at my undies. I don't have a jacket on.
Also, we will be eating on stream tonight.
As we do. It's kind of a House of X, a palooza.
Dodge said that he'd rather peek at your undies.
Good times. Well,
I think they're blue.
You know what? I'm going to show off my
Kathy Waffle shirt. You wear your Kathy... Mine's in the dirty clothes because I wear it the other day. Hers is in the dirty clothes.
Liz wears it every day. Finally, I was like, Liz,
I wore it the
you
other day.
Stink.
And I realized, I realized that I did get a size too big. So, I don't know. Maybe I'll turn it into a crop top.
Anyways.
Make it comfortable.
We love you, Kathy. Hope you're doing good.
I have sugar all over the place. Yes, it is super comfy.
Keeping it real, keeping it old school. All right, so let's get my camera into position and do some finagling. Control. And then try to get it in the right spot. So Giz.
That's not
Giz. What's happening? Guess what?
Chicken butt.
I said guess what and Liz at the same time. That's how it goes.
Dodge, we didn't make anything. Taylor loves us so very much. And
she
so she went and got us Taco Bell.
Right.
It's been a day. So what did you have for dinner? What did everybody else have for dinner? Is anyone else out there? Hello.
Can you hear me? All right. So this is where we ended up last time. This is my son's birthday present that didn't happen at birthday, his birthday, and now it's maybe a Christmas gift that we are desperately trying to, I am desperately trying to finish. So yep. Let's get on it. Let's take it to the bridge.
Let me turn my mic off so you don't listen to my clickety clack.
Clickety clack.
Don't come back. Check.
That's right. Gold. Want to use the Reaper Super Washes. Except I lost the one color I really wanted to use. I don't know where it went. We'll just make one then, maybe, huh? Bloodthirster. And we'll do some blue. Drow Violet. No, I'm going to just blue.
Okay, I'm back. Cannot wait until my daughter can drive. How many more years do you have until that is a thing?
Blessed day.
Man, I just keep getting ads. I am freezing. Like, so our heat is 2.5 years. That's not too bad. But that's still a ways away. For sure.
It's like decades.
You're a decade.
Alright. There we go. Away. Paint is coming out.
I kinda wish that I had made you play music tonight, but it's okay.
I didn't even think about that.
No worries.
I've other things in my mind, like Christmas gifts, birthday presents getting done by Christmas.
That's also true.
That is the appropriate appropriation.
We've been... Oh my gosh, I still forgot to get my dad's gift. Mom finally sent me...
Oh, she did finally sent you that over?
Yeah, but I forgot to get it, so I'll
the
get
deal.
She was like, listen. Give it in a minute.
This is the deal, yo.
Oh, I'm freezing.
All right, so...
Some berry white.
How about Barry Manilow? Mantelope.
Mantelope.
I'm wondering how much of this I should actually do or just airbrush. We are under a time crunch, so maybe we'll airbrush more than paintbrush.
Do it. Do it.
I mean, it is the House of X show after all. We know Dodge gets a little testy when I don't airbrush as much.
You're a little testy. Man, why is... Does anyone else out there have T-Mobile and have issues with T-Mobile?
That would be everyone.
I'm...
We are so over it. It's not even funny.
It is... Dutch. What? It S bracket. Come on. I just need you to download
everything.
Whatever this is. I don't even think it's a photo. I think my dad. I don't know. Aridin. Hello, honey. How are you doing? Thank you so much, Shatterspawn, for the resub. We only have a T-Mobile hotspot. Our provider is Verizon.
You are fortunate.
Yeah, I'm really close to seeing if AT&T would be any better. We have T-Mobile, and it sucks.
To be fair, we weren't T-Mobile. We didn't sign up for T-Mobile. We were on Sprint, and Sprint was okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, not too bad.
Sprint worked pretty damn good, and then...
They got bought.
Got bought out by T-Mobile, and now
they're like, you know, it'd be really cool is if we make it so people can't even get phone calls. Let's try that.
Yeah,
that sounds like a great idea. With
love
the
it, love it so much. Just playing some Guilders too. Sweet. I am not. I'm waiting for dinner to get here. really depends on your location. So we we are like right next, like I'm not kidding, literally like 3 miles away from the T-Mobile store.
Their phones work great there.
Yeah. So like when you're at the T-Mobile store,
complaining,
full signal, full everything, and then you come to our house and it's nothing. I love it.
It went, but it's not just at our house. It's like all over the place, except for right at the T-Mobile store. Like it's like that's the only place their phones really work.
Yeah, exactly. I don't understand. My dad sent something. Maybe it'll come through on your phone. Maybe it won't. It was to the family chat, so we'll see. We'll find out. Find out what happens.
That being said, these Reaper superwashes do work pretty awesome. I like them. Even when you're not washing stuff.
What it's like at our cabin. Can't get calls at all, but T-Mobile works great there. It's so freaking weird. Like, I don't understand it.
We're in the ultimate dead zone or something. Like,
I don't know. It doesn't make any sense. Every living thing that comes in contact with Peach's house just dies.
Very true.
I hope not. My daughter loves Steven. Oh my gosh. Nezuko. Dude, seriously. Okay. Aaron's daughter bought this for me. It's my little Nezuko that sits on my desk. Because she's so stinking cute. Demon Slayer and me are just like best friends.
Didn't Jordan get you something like that too?
Maybe that's what I just said.
You said you're my daughter.
I say you're daughter?
Yeah, you did.
Okay, don't tell Jordan that I called him your daughter. I think I've done that.
I was like, holy cow, Taylor got you one too? I'm like, dang.
I think I called him my daughter. I think I called him your daughter once before too. And then he just laughed.
I mean, he is like 6'4".
I met his son. Y'all, I told you, I still have a migraine. It's like.
It is what it is.
It's dead.
Oh, my brush was all wet, and I shook up this paint, and got flicked.
What?
Got flicked with paint.
Got flipped?
Flickety flicked with the paints. Of course, this will be one of those nights where I can't even find black. The win. Reapers, Dragon Black. Best black on the market. Write that down. Hashtag best black. All right. rock and roll, baby. We need to get to the airbrush part as quickly as possible.
Why do you think I now have to live in Peach's PC? Because her house can only be UFI. Aridin's essentially a ghost. My daughter cried at the end of the movie. Oh my gosh, yes. Oh my gosh, I know the Flame of Shira. I don't want to like spoilerize. My brain is not working. Just FYI.
Spoily McSpoilerton.
Easy to spoil, but such a great, it really is. I just love it. I watched it through twice, and I swear I could watch it all over again.
I'll bet you could.
Brain never works. We'd be doomed if it did. Pretty much. I think our dinner is here.
Oh yeah. I know not everyone celebrates Christmas, but what are you guys doing for whatever holiday
for
you are
celebrating?
My plan is to eat.
That's
usually my plan with any holiday. Yeah. That's what I look forward to most as an adult. Not so big on the presents as much anymore, except for the kids. I like the presents with the kids. But I'm all about the food now. So any good holiday traditions out there? What's your favorite rump roast? Or you guys just do Taco Bell for Christmas morning? That's all acceptable. Or are you guys on diets already? That's also a acceptable. Like, I'm pre-dieting. I'm not gonna eat anything for holidays at all.
Not even a pickle could stop Peach's full-powered brain. True. Okay, Shadow Spawn said, serious question for you: with the plethora of grays on the market, why do you mix one?
I don't know. Because I can control, one, I don't have to get a bottle of gray off the wall. That's laziness, number one. Two, I can mix the tone I want. So grays can be warm or cool or whatever. This gray is going up to being like it's going to be this color eventually, maybe, or that's like mid-tone. So I want to keep it in that family, so I just put that in my black. It's pretty, you know, self-explanatory, I guess. I don't know. But, I mean, yes, you are completely correct. Like, a lot of times I will pick up, Reaper has a lot of really cool grays. Not just cool, they have warm grays, too. But I really like, what is it, Rainy? rainy day or cloudy gray or something like that. That was a fantastic color. But I just, on this particular thing, I wanted to be close to, and I didn't even pick that color because that's the color I wanted to be. It was the color that was on my desk. So, but it will work for what I want to do. And so if I want to keep it in the same family-ish, I just go that way.
Erden said, eat till I die, then come back to life so I can keep eating.
There you go.
Yes. Dodge said, we'll be going to my in-laws again. Garlic cheese grits on Christmas morning.
Wait, where do you live?
And
give me an address.
Okay. Oh, you mean tell Dad not to cook breakfast?
Yeah, I'm going to Dodge's house.
Oh, that's kind of
dad rolls. I almost said Gareth's.
You almost said Gareth, yeah.
No, well,
and cinnamon rolls for the ladies since they don't like grits. They don't like grits.
What's wrong with them?
That makes me so sad.
That would be the first, like, you're out of this family, like, right now. You know, if I was a kid, I'd probably say the same thing. I'd be like, grits? What the heck? What are you doing?
Shadow Spawn said, I go on a shopping spree for myself and have a ham steak, mashed potatoes, and green beans. That
yes.
sounds yummy.
That does sound yummy.
So we usually go to my parents' house for breakfast. My dad makes grits and eggs and gravy and bacon.
And it's awesome.
And sausage. And then I usually make biscuits. Homemade buttermilk biscuits.
Butter to
the milk.
We're
Southern, and that's just how it works.
Butter laying it to the bone, baby.
Biscuits, gravy, and grits.
Yeah, and your dad's gravy is like lights out.
It's always super yummy.
West Coast in the house.
Tash said, oh my god, don't worry about coming to my house, Aaron. I'll bring the grits to Liz's dad's place.
Okay.
Perfect.
Probably a good idea, buddy.
That's perfect.
Not gonna lie, it's probably a good idea.
Okay.
I think Taylor's friggin' eating our food. I think she just bailed with it.
No, babe, it's on the counter. She already dropped it off.
I think she took it to her room and she's like, screw those guys.
No, she put it on the counter by the stove.
Right, we can agree to disagree.
Ian, I see you in here. Where you at?
It's playing it cool. So anyways, Liz, you remember when I said I will never do Twitch ever,
and then
except for Reaper Vex show. I will do Twitch, but we will never have a Twitch account or any of that stuff because it just doesn't interest me, and we got a lot going on, and yada, yada, yada. And that's where we just started.
We started a Twitch.
Yeah.
For those of you who don't know, sorry, I've got like 8,000 notifications on my phone. I'm trying to swipe them away.
Swipey McSwiperton. But we just started to do a Twitch program. That will not affect the Reaper Vex show at all.
No.
In fact, we're doing two Reaper Vexes this month.
Yes. Okay, so I have things. Mother of Pearls. That's not what I wanted. Hold on. 1 second.
Part of the reasoning behind that is if I don't finish this model tonight, I need to finish it. And I got, so So, yeah. We may have one more Reboot Gilliman Reprovec show just to finish this guy off so that I can get my kid a Christmas present. Because otherwise, he's not getting anything.
Oh, that's not true.
That is a lie.
That is not true.
That is a total lie. But we have to lie to ourselves sometimes to get things done. So this will get done one way or the other.
I have not had buttermilk biscuits in ages. I miss them.
Come on over.
I'll make you some Irritin. If you come to any conventions next year, I'll make you some buttermilk biscuits.
If you don't think that's the truth, well, we made French toast last year at ReaperCon, so we'll figure it out.
Yeah, but babe, buttermilk biscuits have to be baked. Are you gonna bring a toaster
airplane? Yes, we will. If it's for Airden, yes.
Actually, I probably could get somebody to bring it.
That's actually a lie, but we could get somebody to bring it to us. We'll end up burning down the hotel.
Or I'll just bring you some buttermilk. There's Ian. Is that the soothing sounds of Aaron Lovejoy? No.
That's actually Liz.
That's me, hun. That's me. But yes, it was Aaron. Those are his gross hands. I say gross because they're covered in primer.
Primer, yeah. We started our sister's battle commission, and it is so hard to get primer off your fingernails.
Like, yeah.
Fingers, no problem. Fingernails, different story.
I'm about to go grab my food and my drink off the counter.
Can you grab mine too?
Am I echoing? Like echo, or is it just like? It's like I'm in an echo chamber. I don't know.
Uh-oh.
We're trying to figure shit out. Now you're not an echo. Okay. Maybe I was too loud. Or maybe Aaron needs to turn his mic down some more.
Some more?
Yeah.
Turn it down some more. Can people hear me?
Yeah, they can hear you just fine.
Okay.
You have no problem projecting. How dare you get a kid a gift and not just give them the pickle? Yeah, Jordan's got plenty of gifts. He's also not a kid.
Yeah, he's like a man.
Both of Aaron's kids are
adult,
full grown
freaks.
They adults.
They're freaky.
Ask a local to bring in a toaster oven. Yeah, I probably could do that.
Yeah.
Aaron, they make things called gloves, bro. He has gloves, Ian. He has gloves.
Yeah, I don't use them when I'm. It's too cumbersome.
Yeah, it's a tiny echo. Not a big deal. Okay.
It's cucumbersome.
Well, hopefully it doesn't keep echoing. I don't know. Maybe my mic needs to be turned down, or I don't know. Thermal Vat Band is awesome. Thanks for the recommendation.
It is, isn't
it? Oh, babe, you need to send that to Ian, to Iron Tusk, because I think I mentioned it to him.
What, the link?
The
Thermal Vat Band?
Yeah.
Website?
Send Aaron nudes.
Yeah.
I mean, I will, but like, he won't get them.
Not for a couple weeks, probably.
He doesn't care. He'd be like, okay, cool.
I'm here.
Okay, I do need to get...
Living the loca. The loca la vida.
Loca la vida? I need to go get my food and my Coke because my head is like...
Throbalicious.
Yeah. Okay, I will be right back. Have a fun time just staring at my chair. Oh, he's making all kinds of brackets.
Rush brown. Wrong color, but we're using it.
You don't have to yell, baby.
But I like to yell. Oh, God, it is the wrong color.
Oh. I have to pee, actually. So I'm going to go pee.
Lizzie's got to pee, just so everyone knows. All right. Get a little bit closer. Ah. There we go. That's not that bad, actually. Yapple Zapple. Purity seals. You gotta love them, baby. Purity seals. What's for dinner? I think my son will like this, though. He's, just recently got into 40K and stuff. All those years of him sleeping under the game, the gaming table at the game store, I think came back. I used to have this fear that I would leave him at the game store, like get home from gaming, and he will have been so quiet that I forgot him there. That would have been bad. Never happened. But it was one of those things as a dad you just sort of freak out about a little bit. Too excited playing those games and then split.
You sure died with Coke?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. It's like a Slurpee on wheels.
Taylor
got
Coke from my house.
Oh yeah. They have better Coke there.
Well, because it's actual Coke.
Oh yeah.
Pepsi.
Oh, because, because of things.
Because I don't want...
Yeah, Taco Bell has Pepsi.
Okay, so...
So we'll make these purity seals a little bit dotty. Yeah, what's going on? We are so used to ordering out for food, like especially during COVID and stuff, and just the wrong order showing up. And just... We got to the point where you kind of just accept that that's what's going to happen and you eat whatever they give you. I don't know if that's the greatest thing ever, but let's put that right on this box.
Okay.
All right. Got it. We're on it.
Yeah.
Breaking the law. Now we can use our Reaper Rusty Red because it's very orangey. Maybe this will be a highlight for our red. Definitely... The red I was using is very, very vibrant, but I didn't insist on it enough to be that vibrant. So.
Excuse me while I eat like 10 tons of Taco Bell.
Liz is eating 10 tons of Taco Bell. Don't be jealous, you guys. Don't be jealous, Ian. Taco Bell's going down.
Liz, about to gobble it.
That's right. We call her the
gobbler. Swallow it. Sorry.
I don't think that means what you think it means.
That was not what I meant. Oops.
Taco Bell Twitch. We're talking about Taco Bell.
Aaron, kiss my butt.
Yeah.
Not
after she eats Taco Bell, though. That is a definitely no-fly zone. After Taco Bell.
No.
You don't get gassy? You don't get gassy?
No.
Okay. Well,
you're
maybe
the one
for
that
me.
Gets gassy. I get
that's
burpy.
Right. Well,
so don't come near my face. I will burp in your face. Can't
she's
help it.
Gonna burp
that's
in
just
your
me
face.
Hold up. Should we not be painting reefer minis on a Reaper stream? We don't have to. We do what we want.
Yeah.
you know.
And it has nothing to do with like we don't like Reaper or something, but we asked right off the bat and
yeah.
And
so like Aaron can work on commissions and stuff if he needs to or
yeah. It's kinda whatever. But we do paint a lot of Reaper minis on the Reaper Vec show. But this was something that I have to get done.
Yeah.
And this is a good time to do it. So don't you fret. We will definitely have Reaper minis on Reaper Vex.
Such a goose. Just such a goose.
In fact, I think when we first started talking to them about doing Reaper Vex, that was one of our questions. We're like, you know, don't worry, we'll paint just Reaper stuff. And they're like, what are you talking about? Ed paints GW stuff on his show. So we're like, well, if the owner does it, then so. Cool beans. One thing I really love about Reaper is they're not so. They're very open to everything, really.
Yeah. Reaper is amazing, honestly. How'd you know it was a goose peach? I am just smart like that. Oh, that is. Lid is like not sticking on correctly. Is Reaper gonna have you do another box art piece for Bone 6?
I don't know. It's
life is.
Ryan has my number.
Yep. Life is crazy and hectic, and we haven't heard anything, but who knows?
And Reaper does have quite a few painters painting stuff for them, so you know we kind of.
Like the 30th anniversary dragon.
Oh yeah, that would be
cool. Would be super cool.
You know, the one I want to paint is the Aaron dragon.
Yeah.
Whatever it was called. Shakarin. The Aaron dragon.
I can't remember the name of it. Dodge may know. Or if Zox is watching, Zox would know.
Yeah. Zox keeps track of dragons named after me. Like his second job.
Zox is like our. Pays attention to shit.
Yeah, he does. He's super smart. That's probably why he's super smart.
4% pickle. That's true. You should paint that one. Yeah, that would be super cool. I'm gonna mute. That way y'all don't have to hear me crunching on food.
It was pretty funny because when we delivered the last dragon to Reaper, Ron was talking. He's like, yeah, you know, we're he kind of with a big smile on his face, because like he's in tune pretty much, you know, he knows that I put a lot of work into that dragon and it took a while to paint, and so he's just kind of smiling. He goes, yeah, we have this idea that we're going to get a bunch of the painters to all paint the same dragon over the year, and you know, it'd be kind of cool to see everyone's take on the same dragon. And he goes, but I do realize that you may be all over dragons right now. I was like, we both just kind of laughed. And the funny thing is, I totally would have done it. But I was also a little dragon burned out at that point. But not anymore. It's funny how that fades. Do a big project and sometimes you get a little burnt out. It's kind of like zombies. When I did the zombie side project, you know, I painted 2,000 zombies or close to that. And yeah, I was pretty done with zombies when I got finished. So I was like, forget that. But I still love painting zombies to this day. So it fades. It's like childbirth. You know, you forget the pain after a while, so to speak. Hashtag.
Yeah, dodge that one. Charandar. Charandar.
Yeah.
The cruel.
That's it. Just in case you're wondering, this is, I mean, I want this to look good, but it is definitely not to studio level. This is, get it pretty darn good, and we're good with it. So, not going to go, there will be mistakes if you're counting them. There will be plenty, don't worry. Don't worry, Dodge. There'll be plenty of mistakes.
I painted 4 zombies and I'm done with them. Couldn't imagine 2,000. Yeah, Shadow Spawn. 2,000 is a lot.
It's you know, when you wake up and you're almost in tears because you're painting zombies for like the 6th month straight. Yeah, it was a lot.
My food is here. Okay, no worries, Iridan. Go eat. Dodge said I painted the kobolds from Bones 5 and never want to look at another kobold. I don't blame you. That was a lot. I couldn't. Oh my god, it was so good.
How good is it?
It was so good.
So one thing's good about doing speed painting, if you want to up your painting game a little bit, is you can get pretty good at just eyeballing where colors should go, because you're going fast, not worried about blending or messing up really. It's just a matter of like, where does a color look good? Where does a highlight look good? You can kind of start, you may not figure it out in your first couple paint jobs, but you'll start figuring it out pretty fast, like, oh, this looks really nice right here. And then you move on to the next one and find out where that one looks good. And you move on to the next one. You know what happens after that, Liz? You move on to the next one.
Yeah.
And so on and so forth. So saith the Lord.
Shadow Spawn said, about six of anything and I am done. Kobolds, goblins, etc.
I get you. I feel you. Mm. Oh, God. I need to. Gonna take a quick 17-second break for me to wolf down this delicious taco from our sponsor, Taco Bell. They're not our sponsor. We all know hard tacos are not nearly as good when they're all soggy, so. I'm sure there'll be someone who come in right while we're eating, and they came in right while we were eating last time. They're like, man, these guys, all they do is eat.
I mean, I didn't get this chunky without eating, so luckily I only, I'm losing my lettuce.
It takes,
luckily I only paint for me, not for a game or anyone else, so I can get away with that. That is true. Nothing wrong with Taco Hell, that's exactly right. I love Taco Hell.
When I was kids, we'd go up to the front desk at Taco Bell, like to the cash register, and be like, hey, could I get, and we'd have like sour cream all over our face. We'd just smear it on. We're like, hey, do you guys have any napkins? Super serious. And then our goal was to get the person behind the counter to laugh. That was pretty funny. It's not sour cream, baby.
Ugh, gross.
Whoa. It was cottage cheese.
God. Ew. Man.
What was that show where they had burritos?
What?
There was a show where they called them burritos. It's like a bunch of stoners or something. God, I can't remember. It was a super funny show.
I don't know.
They were all like college kids.
Our Mexican restaurant here is actually pretty dang good. Actually, I forgot we had leftovers. We could have had that. Maybe we'll do that for breakfast before we go help my best friend move again.
For the third time this year.
Yeah, bless her heart. Come on. Burrito.
All right. Just so you know, Dodge, I'm not going to starve. I've got nacho bel grande, but they're much easier to eat while you're painting. If In fact, I can probably eat while I'm painting, literally.
I'm just making a mess. I have paper everywhere.
Rock on.
You rock on.
Okay. Let's see if we can do something funky here. Funky monkey. Maybe not.
No Crunchwrap. No Crunchwrap. I like the, what did I just eat?
Some Taco Bell.
Excuse me.
Wow.
I forgot to mute. You're
welcome. That'll be on the House of X highlight show.
I know, sorry. What was it that I just ate? While I look back through my text messages to figure out what my order was.
Welcome, Failing at Life 101 by Liz Hunt.
I've had a migraine all day.
She did.
So, like, it's been rough. But it was a cheesy gordita crunch, and it was delicious.
Gordita. You're my cheesy gordita.
You're a cheesy gordita.
We don't need another gordita.
I thought that was Aaron. No, Aaron can't burp the way I can.
I can.
I will beat him every time in a burp match, I promise.
Yeah, probably.
Farting, on the other hand.
Oh, I got
Aaron
you.
Aaron will murder
you.
Ain't
everyone. Got nothing.
I almost went to Taco Bell today, but I'm too cheap to eat out. Nothing wrong with that either. Save that money. Especially with the holidays. Like,
keeping it real. Keeping it gangsta.
The only reason we got Taco Bell was because Aaron's daughter was like, I got paid today.
Yeah. And, like, honestly, I was like, you know what, I don't need dinner at all. And then she said that, and I suddenly was hungry.
Yeah.
It's funny how that works.
I was going to make ramen, so. You know. We real healthy.
Keep it simple.
How are you doing?
I'm gonna eat my.
I do not want that meat. On there. That's right. No, no, no.
No, no, no. Oh, so good. That was just sour cream.
There's nothing wrong with that.
It was just a mouthful of.
Sour cream.
Tortilla and sour cream.
I don't know why, but, like, restaurant sour cream is so much better than, like, you can buy at the store. It just tastes different. I don't know what it is. Does anyone else know what it is?
Yeah, Dodge. We will be teaching at AdeptCon. I think, did classes go up yet? Or?
No, I think it's January 8th they go up. Okay. It used to be up, like, pre-November, I think.
Yeah.
But they have definitely, since COVID, they've kind of rocked it back a little bit. I think it's easier for them to.
Mm-hmm. Hello, Trash. How are you doing tonight? Welcome to the House of Burrito, pretty much. And I literally just got a mouthful of sour cream.
Is that what you're calling it?
Is the difference. See, I told you, you and Iron Tusk were like, the same.
Keeping a gangster.
Spitting semen. Reaper should make you a House of X pokey tool. It could be a mini airbrush. That would be super cute.
That would be so awesome. Actually, if it was a tool that cleaned your nozzle, that would be freaking amazing. And it doubles as cleaning your paint bottles. I think I'm onto something. I don't want to know what shape Dodge wants it to be in. I'd probably get kicked off of Twitch with that.
No shiz, I had a chicken burrito for dinner. Mexican place brought me a burrito the size of my head. Oh my god, that sounds so good.
Oh man.
It sounds like a San Diego burrito.
Sounds like a West Coast burrito, yeah. For sure. Oh, show.
I will tell you, Mount, my invention, a three-rito, a burrito within a burrito within a burrito.
gosh darn it. There goes my whole bottle of Reichlin Flesh Aid.
Oh.
Into the puddle bed.
I didn't know what that noise was, and I thought that you just had like a...
Me screwing up.
An orgasm over a three-rito.
I might have been part of it. Hey, we can actually take stuff off the paddle pad onto my palate.
There the paddle go. Pad?
The paddle pad.
Aaron, I heard your cousin is back in the studio with Limp Bizkit right now.
Yeah, probably.
A burrito inception. I'd eat it. All I'd stuff that. Well,
so much for that. That was a brand new bottle, too. Holy moly.
Well, that sucks.
I think Games Workshop actually makes their wash bottles like so they fall like will fall over. That would make it sell more. Probably not the truth, but I like to think it is. Three Rito. That sounds kind of eerily like Human Centipede. My three dogs.
What?
The first thing the doctor put together in Human Centipede was not a human. It was his dog. He had three German Shepherds, I think.
I can't believe you actually watched that movie.
I did. It was disconcerting. But they say that the second one, which I did not watch, was actually gnarly, worse than the first, because the guy wasn't really a doctor. He was just trying to pick up where the other guy left off, and he didn't use anesthesia, so he just cut people into pieces while they were awake. That's pretty gnarly.
That's gross. so, Ian, the pokey tool that Shadow Spawn is saying, like the pokey tools that you use to unclog a paint pot. Oh, John, sweetheart. I'm glad that you came in now and not like late earlier, because, well, it's House of X. You know, it's life. what was I saying? Forgot. I lost track. Oh, pokey tools. Pokey tools. Why am I doing that? Hand motion. Pokey tools.
What hand motion did you use?
I was doing this.
It's okay. We're talking about paint pokey tools.
God. Okay. But they open up, or they unclog paint things.
I have a pokey
yeah,
tool.
Yeah, of course I'm echoing again because I got too loud. Because Aaron's mic still is up too loud.
I'm like all the way. Okay, now we're at the bottom of the barrel.
That's where it should be. So,
can people still hear me? Hear me? Can I hear me?
Babe, you're super loud, so yeah.
Can you I'm hear sure me people can with still the normal hear you. Voice?
Anyways. But he was saying that, so Reaper makes, they have like a skull pokey tool. It's essentially just a needle with a little metal end to poke stuff. Oh my god. John. You clipped it.
Did. We're just trying to raise viewership for House of X.
Oh my gosh. Jeeves. Thanks, John. Love you too. Airbrush versions. So it's an... Like an airbrush print, like a little airbrush thing on a pin. That's what Shadow Swan was talking about. Oh, so I still gotta eat my burrito. I got halfway done.
So what we want is we want a Reaper airbrush cleaner that's like a pokey tool, but you use it to clean your nozzle out. And it'll be in the shape of an airbrush with the pokier thing.
Sure.
That would be sick. Hashtag, write that down.
Iron Joy Industries should make one.
Yeah, there we go. There's no I in team, but there is an I in Iron Joy Industries.
Oh,
or so they say.
I have to go watch this.
How about Iron Member Membistries? And the member is the Iron Pokey Tool.
I just watched that clip. Man, I was just like...
You were going at it.
I was.
Very animated.
I was. I posted in my Discord as well. In the Shits and Giggles channel.
Stuff you're missing.
Man.
Ripe now. Now.
I used to play WoW with a dude who was... who would shoot Hort Tranquilizer in his foot since he was under house arrest for heroin possession. Oh my god.
What would he shoot in his foot?
Horse Tranquilizer.
Where do I get some of that?
Just you
kidding.
Don't.
Just kidding.
Hey,
wow.
You're afraid
you looked
to
up real quick off that.
Yeah. You're afraid to take ibuprofen.
That's fine.
So, I don't worry
horse
about
tranquilizer
you.
Is completely different. Just a second more. This will be the best model my son has. And I know that because I painted the other models he has. Mm-hmm. I don't remember the blue I used last time, so we'll just start fishing for blues.
That scale modder.
It is a scale modder. Let me tell you something, Liz. He'll really run strong in you.
Fuck you. That scale model color is a personal fave. Which one? The one that's like sitting on the left?
Oh, the yeah. The,
I don't know. I'm
is this
asking.
Citrine?
I'm just asking.
This one's citrine. This one's yellow. Like gold or
that one.
No, amber.
That one.
Which one?
Oh, I don't know. He said the yellowish one.
The yellow one was on screen, so I'm guessing that was it.
Probably.
So this is the highlight color for gold. It's called citrine.
Oh, never mind. It's not the right one.
Okay. Well, never mind then. Carry on.
Yep. So if this 40K movie takes off, who's Henry Cavill going to play?
They actually asked me to play it. Just kidding.
No. I don't know. But I am excited. I think it'll be great. Also, I love Henry Cavill. So
with how many cool like CGI things, like fan based ones there are out there, they've got to do it. Like,
yeah.
I think it would be home run.
Yeah, I think so too. Jeez, Liz, the burrito hit you hard. It did. 100%.
But
excuse me. Sorry.
So we will. I was a bit messy with my gold.
Excuse me. The one I was thinking was Moonlight Yellow. Oh. Citrine is what I call Reaper John on Discord.
I will have to remember that.
Right?
From now on, this color is John. It's Reaper John.
Reaper John. We'll just... Oh, I have 5% left on my phone.
Ooh.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Take me to the river. I don't know what that means.
I don't know what that means either.
No, just when you think you've painted all the gold on this mini, there's more gold to paint. Oh my gosh, this whole arm part. Whoa.
Henry will play Ricardo Montalban. I don't know who that is. I don't know much of anything. I am Jon Snow.
Oh, man. Oh, boy.
Sweetheart, you should know I don't know names. Fantasy Island, Star Trek, nope. Did you see that news story about the coke addict who snorted his grandmother's ashes? He snorted a half a gran. Trash.
Okay. It is bad joke time.
That was a great joke. I love it. I don't know why my head has been hurting so bad.
No one knows for sure.
Be back in a bit. Gotta feed my monster and kid.
That?
Okie dokie.
Not sure that came out right.
We'll see you in just a bit.
You have 17 minutes. That.
Heather, hello, hun. How are you doing? Oh my gosh. Gross. I'm so cold. Good. Good, good, good. She submitted her entry. I need to. Gotta start putting everything in the spreadsheet. Burrito in your throat. That's what she said.
Coming around the mountain, Liz.
What?
I said we are coming around the mountain.
you're coming around the mountain.
Helicopter coming by the house?
Yeah, that was my mouth.
Is that what we call your mouth, the helicopter?
I don't know how to take that.
I'm out of here.
Hey, Andy, how's it going? It's Andy Lorenz, by the way.
What's up, dog? Andy is my only friend here in Georgia. And he's always working, so he can never come visit me. It is what it is.
So Monolith opened up the pledge manager for that Batman Minis game and RPG. My wallet is scared. Aw. You did, Andy. You caught us live. We're here.
I'm trying to keep my hand from going in the big puddle of Reiklin flesh aid that's on my palette. That's
well, nobody can see it, so.
Yeah, I know, but my hand feels it every time I stick it in it.
That's what she said.
That's the problem. Wah, wah.
But I have nothing funny to say. That's okay. We're like half asleep, so. Speaking of live, how goes Affiliate Quest on Miniature Monthly channel? I'm going to be completely honest. I don't know. I'm not logged into Miniature Monthly, so I can't check. I think the only thing we need is we just need to meet the like stream 7 days or something like that.
Yeah.
Kenny! Hello,
yeah,
love.
That's the problem.
How are you doing? Those aren't my hands, by the way. See, these are my hands. Those are Aaron's.
Man hands.
Aaron's primed.
Grody. Gross hands.
Primered hands.
Whoop. Get him a.
Get Aaron a straw. He can suck up all the spilled wash and he can spit it back in the jar. Problem solved.
They do call me the
spitter. He is a spitter. Bless his heart.
Oh, Lord. Lord, help us all.
I'm sorry. I've had a migraine all day. For those of you who are just now coming in.
You're welcome.
Also, this is normal. Aaron has perfectly manicured nails. We know the truth. Right. Not quite. Just wanted to slap a follow on it. We'll catch you later. No worries, Kenny. Thank you for dropping by. We appreciate you. So what everybody have for dinner? That's usually the question we ask. Boop, boop. granola, whipped cream, and blueberries. That sounds pretty good, actually. I brought with kraut and onion rings. Oh, my gosh. Heather, you're killing me. The burrito. Oh, yeah, that's right. Trash. We did talk about that. A few tips of contrast paint. Oh, bless.
Anyone else painting tonight? Or is it just me? Everyone else is like, it's Friday, I'm done.
That's how I feel.
We used to, our paint night was always Friday night back in San Diego. We would get down. I'm trying to set one up here.
He's trying to make new friends.
I'm trying desperately to make new friends.
I love it, though. I think it's going.
I'm best friends with a 15-year-old down at the game store.
Don't say that out loud.
The only person who would talk to me.
Don't say that out loud.
Or the only person who came up and talked to me.
Yeah.
I'm not best friends with him, but that was the only person I've talked to at the game store was a 15-year-old because he was either bold enough to come up and talk to me while I was painting or, I don't know, where everyone else knows to be scared of me. Who knows?
The death card never end. You got this, Andy. I painted a chibi model earlier. I was thinking of painting a board game. You should do it, Trash. I'm really good at telling people they should paint.
And then not painting yourself.
And then I don't paint. I mean, I will have to paint because I do have to help you with that commission. But, man, why is my head? My head is still hurting. I don't get it.
It is pretty safe to say I will never paint this model again. Unless somebody commissions me. There's so much friggin' gold trim on that. It's just like, I'll probably send it to him, and then like a year later I'll see it again, and I'll be like, oh, there's all the gold trim I missed. I guess there could be worse things, but.
True.
It's just a lot of gold trim. I get it. He's the leader, but still. Imperium of Man went broke when they built his armor. So much gold on it.
I recommend Stuffed Fables for a kid's kind of chibi board game with cool minis. I don't think I've heard of that one. On the stack is Mice and Mystics, Descent 2, or Descent 2nd Edition, Shadows of Brimstone and Hate. Get that Shadows of Brimstone on.
Get the Shadows. That is correct. You guys ever finish watching the, whatever that British sci-fi show is called? God, I can't believe I forgot the name. The one with the Daleks.
Oh, the Daleks? You mean Doctor Who?
Doctor Who, yeah.
We have not fully caught up, no.
Okay.
We're also behind on Critical Role. So, like, we're
I noticed you guys kind of jump. Like, you'll watch something for a while, and then maybe you just get sort of sick of it.
Well, it wasn't.
Come back to it.
It kind of was that, but then also, like, we just kind of got busy. And so that was why we went from watching Doctor Who, and then we started watching Critical Role. Well, I was already watching Critical Role, but then Taylor like super got into it, and so then I don't watch it without her. So, yes, Andy, we did see that. It's super exciting. Heather said I did lots of finishing entries on my entry this morning, and took about 800 pictures this evening. One benefit of in-person contests. Not having to get the perfect shots. So true.
Very true.
I have the curse of if I paint a game, I'll never play again. Trash, that happens.
The opposite for most people. Yeah,
that happens, Trash. Well, God dang it. Come on now. I feel like one of these days I'm going to end up getting myself cordless headset. I love Critical Role. I worked with Sam Riegel's wife last. That is so exciting. I love Sam Riegel. And And his wife is adorable. I stalk them on Instagrams.
Who's Sam Riegel?
He's the one that plays, he's the one that plays Fresh Cut Grass.
Oh, the one I like.
Yeah, the one you like.
Figures I don't know his name.
Yeah.
That's my favorite guy on the show.
That is your favorite. It's true. I have freaking 3,000 games, so not playing a game again is not a rare thing. That's fair. I didn't know she was the boss, and I was wearing a Critical Role t-shirt, and she freaked out. That's awesome. Beep, beep, deep, boop, boop. Oh, I do like the fact that our I met Travis and Laura back in Texas because I had a bunch of voice actor friends. They were super nice too. They are two of my favorites, but Ashley, she holds my heart.
Which one's Ashley? The one that was on Two Is Enough or something?
I'm sorry. Two Is Enough? What the fuck is that? What did he just say?
What was that? When Six Is a Crowd? I don't know. It's a TV show. Was she on a TV show?
What are you talking about?
I don't know, Ashley.
Well, she was also an actress. She was on Growing Pains.
Growing Pains, that's what I meant. Two Is Enough. Oh, Growing Pains, same
two
thing.
Two Is Enough. Aaron's just making up
two
shows.
Is, two Is a Crowd.
Growing Pains, yeah. She's the blonde that plays Fern.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
She's my favorite. She makes the best. She makes the best, like, facial expressions. I don't know. I just love her. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Okay. People, just in case anybody, Three's Company. I don't think she was in Three's Company, but I could be wrong. Maybe she was a baby kid.
Was she in Two Is Enough?
Two Is Enough is not a show. Is she bleeding?
No, she's eating a nacho chip.
Whoa.
Yeah, she's eating.
Oh,
she's eating it out of my...
Yes.
What are you doing?
She's getting it wrong.
What are you... I didn't put that down there for you. She was licking her lips. She got a bunch of... There's a bunch of slobber in here now.
Oh, my God.
Aaron put his food way too close to the ground, and Marley just walked over there and just started eating his nachos.
She had never done that before.
She hasn't, but you've also never put it, like, on the ground. She thought it was fair game.
She's like, thanks, Dad.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay.
No, I'm just bringing up old-ass shows. She was in that show Seven in the House.
Seven in the House.
Love you dearly, but I'm gonna crash. Talk again soon. We'll see you later, Andy. Thank you for dropping by. Oh my God. I thought Taylor said, "Why are you bleeding?" And she didn't. She said, "What are you eating?" And she had a freaking nacho in her mouth because.
I saw cheese, and
he
was like, "Oh no!"
I don't know where she get cheese. Well, she loves cheese.
No, she's still over here, like. All right, I'm ready for more.
Yeah, she is. She thinks you did that for her. She's sniffing around.
Marley, baby, that was not for you.
I gave her food.
She's such a goose.
But cheese is my favorite.
It puts the cheese into its face.
boop.
Well, we know what her favorite Taco Bell is then.
Freaking nachos.
Nachos. Marley, this is nacho cheese. Yeah, you already know that.
Oh, man. What are you guys doing tonight?
I got half the world searching for Two is Enough TV show. Oh, it's Two is a Crowd.
Two is a Crowd? Three is a Crowd.
Two is Enough.
Speaking of Critical Role, the dude who played the Fonz is going to be a voice. I saw that. I'm super excited.
Wait, Henry Winkler?
Yeah, he's going to be a voice actor on Vox Machina.
Okay.
The next season. I was like,
they have actors on Critical Role. Like, what do they need
a voice actor for in the show?
In the show?
Yeah.
Well, he's a director now, right?
Henry Winkler? Yeah, I think he is. I don't know. Nacho sounds good. Yeah, he always gets his... nachos.
Yeah, this is nacho cheese.
Have a good night. Oh, sorry, I don't know why that was felt so breathy. Have a good night, Dodge.
See you, Dodge.
Sleep well.
Merry Christmas.
I'm in car watching on my radio, silently judging No One Can Play the Fonz.
But it is the Fonz.
You know, we have a statue of the Fonz here. You have a statue of the Fonz at your house, Heather? Cheech? Oh, yeah. Cheech is going to be in there, too. Oh, in Milwaukee. Okay, that makes sense.
I was going to say, at your house? That is a little bit weird.
I was...
Not going to judge, but that's weird.
I was thinking the same thing.
I mean, Happy Days could have been, like, your favorite show ever, and you're just like, dude, we're getting a Fonz statue.
I loved Happy Days growing up. Happy Days and Laverne and Shirley.
Mm-hmm.
God, Laverne and Shirley were my favorite. My cousin and I would always pretend to be Laverne and Shirley. I always got stuck playing Laverne. Checks out. Would be weird about that. That would be cool. I loved Happy Days. Happy Days was so good. Monday, Tuesday, Happy Days. If it was in your bathroom, that would be weird. Maybe. What if the Fonz was like your toilet paper holder? Laverne and Shirley was also placed in... Yeah, they were. It was. I just loved that show. It was so good. I used to know the intro song, like, as a child. I would just sing it all the time. And we never knew, they mentioned, like, a company or something like that in the song, and we could never remember what it was. Also, I just noticed, thanks, Zombie Master, for the follow. I don't hear notifications, so I didn't see it pop up.
Yeah, this is not our main account. This is our side hustle. For Reaper.
Yeah, we do this because we love Reaper.
Also,
we will be streaming again on the 30th.
Here.
Yes, on here.
But we will also be streaming on Miniature Monthly's Twitch. So we're not officially open on Miniature Monthly's Twitch. This is kind of our get to iron
affiliate.
Out the kinks month.
So we're trying to get to affiliate, but hold on, I have it somewhere.
I have to stream 19 more times.
No. We do need to stream more. I just don't remember how many more times. I have to log into the account to check.
So we'll probably be on Sunday night. Today is Friday, right?
Yes, today is Friday, which is why
we're
streaming.
We'll be on Sunday night. And should I do the shadow stuff or the Nurgle stuff? Should Sunday be Shadows of Brimstone because it's my own stuff?
Sure. All right. That could work.
So Sunday, I'll be finishing the Shadows of Brimstone models that we started on the last stream.
Maybe.
These guys, we'll be finishing them up. And then our next stream, which will be sometime early next week, I'll be finishing off this Nurgle commission for Blackstone Fortress. So
yes.
Those guys are almost done. This guy is where we stopped in the first stream that we did, but I'll show how I finish this up. And then I've got all these Poxwalkers that I started yesterday. We'll be finishing those up, and I'm going to do one from the very start. So if you want to see those, go to the Miniature Monthly Twitch page. Sign up for notifications or whatever. Otherwise, we just post them all on YouTube, so you'll see them eventually.
Yeah. Blackstone Fortress painted all of it, never flipping plated again. It happens. It happens.
So I think with these guys, I will have painted the whole series as well. But they don't make it anymore, so it's kind of a bummer. She's just ready.
I think you need to eat your nachos before she, like, gobbles them up.
I'm trying to. Everything's clogged. That's purple. I don't want purple.
What were you trying to get?
Silver. Silvery purple? Close enough, right?
Whatever works. I'm going to have to pee again because I did drink.
Get on it.
Folks at Black Sight Studios are working on a game I'm excited for. It's kind of like a mix of Mordheim and Elden Ring. Ooh. Except it's all in feudal Japan. That sounds super exciting.
Has anyone played or looked out at One Page Rules? I just heard about it recently, and apparently it's One Page Rules, so it's super easy to play. They do have figures, but you
Trash
can play
said
with
yes.
Any figures? Is it any good? Is it too dumbed down? Like, is it too easy? Or is it just right?
Played One Page Rules at ReaperCon. Ruin said One Page Rules is pretty great. Shamil, Shamazel. That's the incorporated one. We would say like Highlands have been incorporated. Like we would just make shit up. Because we can never remember that. But thank you, Heather, for looking it up.
So what are the real words for it?
It's Shlemiel, Shlemazel, Hassan, Pfeiffer Incorporated or something like that. It's like a... Is that a brew?
Yeah, they were at
it
a
means,
brewery, right?
It means rabbit.
It means rabbit.
Maybe. I think it's a brewery.
Eight rabbits on the show.
Trash said it's pretty good. I mean, if you want the crazy in-depth stuff from 40K and such, you ain't getting it. But if you want to just sit down, throw dice, and be done with it, One Page is great. I think that's what Aaron likes. I don't know, maybe. That's me making a decision.
Sometimes yes, sometimes no. Like, it depends, but...
Mm. Iron Tusk just says Q. Was that, like, were you fat-thumbing? It's not a real brewery. It was based on Blatt's. Oh, okay. Marley, why are you...
Don't be a baby.
Why are you being a baby?
She's like, because you've given me the forbidden fruit. Now it's...
Right.
Gone. poor little guy. She's like, that was the best thing I've ever eaten.
She wanted more.
Oops. Yeah, she did. Yeah, she does. Did nothing. She's like hitting the box that it used to be on.
Is she?
Yeah, she's whack-a-moling it. Marley, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Marley.
So is anyone entering the Miniature Monthly contest? Other than Heather. Now I want... You want rabbit? There's a good German restaurant here that makes it.
Ooh.
I'm not a rabbit person. Oh, shoot. Today was...
Your birthday?
No, it's Patrick's birthday, but I don't know if it's my Patrick or your Patrick.
I don't know. Is it Patrick Keith's birthday? Probably not.
No, it would have been my Patrick from college or your Patrick from San Diego.
Mm-hmm.
It just says Patrick's birthday.
Well, that doesn't
super
anything,
helpful.
Does it?
Super, super helpful. So I guess I will text James and find out.
Both of them. Hey, if it's your birthday, happy birthday.
Patrick's B-Day in my phone. Oops. Speaking of your Patrick, we haven't heard from him in a long time.
Just kind of disappeared.
Sad days.
Yeah. Well, he said he was having...
Yeah.
One of our friends passed away.
Yeah.
And he was really close to that guy.
Yeah.
Ray from San Diego. He was a school teacher. He's a cool guy. And Patrick was there kind of helping him at the end, so I think he just really...
Yeah.
You know. And they were, like, super into the hobby together. So, like, it was one of those things where it was just kind of, it was like, you know, he's kind of got to find his way after that. Last time I talked to Patrick, he said they were getting back into playing Shadows of Brimstone and stuff, though, so I don't know if that ended up happening or what.
Who knows?
But they were making their own scenarios and stuff. Like, it was pretty in-depth.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
So what's everyone doing this weekend? Do you have any plans? Nobody's doing anything this weekend. Erden said nope. Ruin said, I'm teaching my nephew how to paint. Had one session so far, I really enjoyed it. That's super exciting. Erin taught our niece how to paint.
Not really. So much taught. I put her in place and she just went for it. Like,
she doesn't like to be told what to do either, so that's probably why. It's my hubby's birthday, but it'll be pretty mellow. Oh, tell your husband happy birthday, Heather. That volume down. I can turn one of my lights around for you.
So I went to the game store this week. So
you did. Hey. We also found out that there's another game store near us too, so we have two game stores.
There's actually three, but one of them we already know.
Yeah, we don't go to that one. We don't speak of that one. Wow, that is super bright right in my eyeballs.
That's right. We don't play around.
Beep, bop, boop. All I hear is Erin just rummaging through the kitchen. There's hobby stuff all over our dining room table. We gotta fix that.
What's that?
So we gotta fix the fact that there's hobby stuff all over my dining room table. I haven't even finished, like, fully decorating for Christmas, and next weekend is Christmas, so.
I mean, you did a pretty good job on what you did.
Well, yeah, but I want to be able to put our, like, centerpiece on the dining room table, but I can't because there's shit
everywhere. That's what we're waiting for.
Yeah, that's what I've been waiting for. That's why there's a candle on the counter, and the wreath is just, like, amongst the craziness that is our mess.
The mess that is.
The mess that is.
I almost said the meth. That's not what that
nope,
is.
Nope, that is incorrect.
False.
The candle in the toilet where it no. I would never put a candle on the toilet. I am way too afraid of fires. So that doesn't happen. I have a candle in the living room on the, like, what's it called? Coffee table. I'm not worried about my, it's more Aaron's farts catching fire, but I'm just more worried about Aaron being super clumsy and then, like, knocking it over and then catching, you know, the whole bathroom on fire.
I've never been clumsy. Poop.
Poop.
Oh. I should have put some, I didn't realize. Well, not like my son would know, but I didn't realize he didn't do some putty around the edge to make it look like it wasn't just base and then model.
Mm-hmm.
That's all right. I can do that later.
I just had deja vu. That was weird.
Mm-hmm.
You ever see that show Nine on the Roof where they catch?
No, but I've seen two is enough. two is a crowd. What if two was a crowd?
Two is a crowd sometimes.
I see the despair every time, every morning when Liz wakes up. Oh God, he's still here.
Oh my gosh.
A dream that you weren't here anymore, but you still paid the bills.
Yeah, thanks.
Wait, what?
Thanks. Thanks for doing that. I'm just
glad to know where I stand.
Palos, hello, hon. How are you doing? How's your night? Doing good. I'm glad to hear that. Packing? You going on a trip? You going someplace for the holidays? Yes, and then some, just a day trip to see my family for Christmas, and then cruise, and then a move. And then a move? Dude, that's a lot of...
A lot of doing.
That's a lot of stuff. Yeah, that is going to be a super crazy January.
It's almost better that it's all at once, though, because it's like, it'll be tiring, but then it's over with. It's not like you get done and you're like, ah, but we have to go do something in a month.
Yep. Also true.
Like this year when we had all those cons, like back to back to back to back, and a move, and visitors from out west. It was like, it was a lot. I'm not going to lie. But it all happened in the same like month and a half period, so it was like, it's a brutal month and a half, and then it's over with.
Yeah, and then you have to unpack. Yeah. So.
We're still not unpacked, are we?
No. There's still boxes in the garage.
From ReaperCon or something?
From... No.
Dice Fest?
There's boxes in the garage from our move.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, but obviously we're not using that stuff, so we're good.
No, but it's all hobby stuff, too, but...
Oh, I've been through those boxes a lot of times, though.
Oh, like, okay.
I know what's in them. They're safer in the box than they are...
True.
Like, that one box is just all, like, models that are on our wish list to paint. They're all really cool, also really in a box.
The whole con season from Memorial Day to Labor Day is always pretty crazy. It really is. Gamma is moving to Kentucky. What? Really? Where is Gamma currently?
They're at the trade show?
Yeah.
Is in Reno now.
Oh, it's in Reno.
Yeah, it was in Las Vegas.
Well, apparently now it's moving to Kentucky.
That's weird.
Hmm.
Well, it's actually pretty close to us, kind of.
Yeah.
Ish.
Ish, yeah. Not that we need another convention, but it would be kind of nice to be able to go to a convention one year.
Gamma is more of like industry convention, though. It's, or at least it was. I don't know about now.
Probably still is. I just want to go to a convention, like, for funsies.
We wouldn't know what to do.
I would.
I immediately volunteer to work somewhere. And
you probably would.
Oh, I would go. I would sleep in the hotel room the whole time. This is amazing.
Come to Origins. It's fun. I don't know. We could. So that's the only downside is like most of the time the conventions that we go to, like we teach, and like that helps pay for our trip because we need to make sure that like. It's going to be worth our time, not only the travel expenses.
But time off work and all
but
that
also
stuff.
Time off of work and all of that kind of stuff. So, like, there's a lot of stuff that we have to weigh in when we go to a convention. And then going for fun, I mean, essentially that would be, like, just full on a vacation. So, like, that, you know, traveling's expensive, too. Atlanta Game Fest, 4 times a year. I hate Atlanta, though. We're 2 hours away from Atlanta. Well, 2.5 hours.
You need a festival in Augusta. I know that sounds weird, but...
Yeah.
That would be super cool.
I mean, they do have, like... There's a Comic-Con here. There's stuff in... Like, I'd rather go to Savannah. So Savannah had a Comic-Con. It was very tiny. Couple of months ago, I went with my cousin and his wife, and that was actually super enjoyable, like, to just be able to go. Yeah, CMON Expo was in, it was in Atlanta. Fun fact, that was the first convention that I ever went to. That was my, like, shoe-in for miniature gaming. I went to CMON Expo, and then I saw Malifaux, and I was like, oh my god, I want to play this. And so then I went ham on Malifaux. Yeah. Yep. Well, Weird Minis, it's not technically in our backyard, because it's still like 2 hours away, but when is Iron Joy Industries Con happening? Ian, we can make it a thing, honey. We can do it.
The only convention no one goes to. Except for the three of us.
Okay. Also, update. Not that anybody cares, but where? We'll have it at my parents' house on their farm. Actually, no, because I don't want creepers showing up at my parents' house. That's a bad idea. We can go, let's go to the mountains. Let's go to the mountains and, like, rent out a bunch of cabins. That'd be amazing. Also, it's my Patrick's birthday, not your Patrick.
I figured my Patrick knew any of his stuff.
I feel like I've lost every of my favorite colors ever. They're all gone.
I'm sorry.
This does look better with the base starting to get painted. Funny how that works. Wolf gray. Write that down.
Super funny. James also forgot, so at least it's not just me. Let's pick a terrible place like Yuma, Arizona. Do a Valhalla
right
up
in
the Smokies. Okay, so trash. Seriously, we are thinking about doing a retreat. I think it'd be amazing. It'd be so much fun. We do that twice a year. A group of friends rent a cabin in the woods to game all weekend. That sounds so much fun.
It sounds like the start of a horror movie.
So
but it sounds fun.
That's
too.
Kind of what you're going to be doing in January. I need friends. I don't get to do stuff like that. I'd love to just like get away for a weekend or something. No offense, babe. I love you, but I think it'd be kind of fun. Like
where do I sign you up for this trip?
Huh?
Where do I sign you up for this trip? No offense.
He's trying to get me out of the house. Are you going to pay for it? Because I'll go.
So I went to the game store and painted one day. I haven't done that in years now. And it was fun. It was a little bit weird, but I get home and Liz is like, how do you do it when I'm gone all day? I was like, well, I party for the first half of the day, and no, I'm just kidding. I think I'm better with doing things by myself, like, period.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't know, I have that innate ability to entertain me or something.
Your idea sounds like a sleepaway, oddly camp mini painting weekend. Yes, that's what I want. We used to do a game festival in Gatlinburg back when we lived in Tennessee. Ugh, sounds like so much fun. Details what's happening in January. He's going with his friends from back home to
Tennessee. Yeah.
For like a weekend or something. You gotta stop building that meth lab and get out of the house sometimes. Yes, he does. Or me. Are you talking about me or are you talking about him? I get out of the house once a week. I go to my best friend's house, and then we drink coffee, and we cry, and we talk about our anxiety, and we talk about the things that had us upset all week. We talk about past trauma. It's our therapy session. And then I come home, and I feel much better.
And then 2 or 3 hours with me, and she's right back to being traumatized.
I didn't say that. I'm sorry I've been so quiet today. I'm trying not to, like, one, I'm trying not to talk too loud because I don't want Aaron's mic to pick me up, but also loud noises hurts my head.
Good times.
Yeah. I think it's a combination between this weather and then me just, like, you know, not taking care of myself. That, you know, eating is a thing that people should do. Just whisper in the mics secrets about Aaron's Christmas presents. He will never know. He will know. So he has selective hearing. So I can literally be sitting right next to him and I'll ask him a question and he won't hear me. But I will be in another room talking about him, whispering, and he'll hear every single word. Selective hearing. My dad also has it.
I think it's one of
the other... I remember mom was like getting on to dad the other day. I clean my mom's house. Well, I try to clean my mom's house once a week for her because she has rheumatoid arthritis from breast cancer, or from the chemo from breast cancer. And I was over there and I was cleaning. Her and my dad were sitting on the couch. And 9 times out of 10, like, my mom will say, or no, mom said something to dad, and he couldn't hear. Like, I had to ask her, like,
right,
3 times what she said. And then I was in the kitchen, and I was talking to her dog, and I was talking, like, with a low voice. And my dad responded to me. He heard every word that I said to the dog.
Wrong move.
And my mom...
You gotta be freaking kidding me. So funny.
And then, so, like, I just hear the two of them laughing, like, really hard in the living room. I was like, what the hell's going on? Dad was in trouble. That's what was going on. It's called selective hearing. First stages of not giving a shit. Aaron's already there.
That's right.
That reminds me of the dad on the show 18 and 7.
Two is a third.
Oh,
three
my God.
Is a fourth. That should be a thing. We should just start bringing up TV shows that never happened.
Yeah.
And, like, talk about it
just
like it's
see.
Actually a thing. Yeah. Like, if you ever meet that girl Ashley, like, at a convention or something, that's what you should do. Like, immediately be like, I loved you on Two is a Third.
No, babe, I've already told, like, if I ever met Ashley Johnson in real life,
I would
freeze up, and yeah, it would be the same thing that happened
when we were
at the same party with
dude.
My brain just went dead.
The one guy. Super cool dude.
Sorry. No, my brain just died. What happened? What happened to my brain? Hold on. Come on, brain. You can do it.
Deuce Bigelow.
No. Fuck. Butts. Trash.
Clearly, he wasn't very important. But
no, he was. It's just, my brain is just...
I was ready to walk over to the guy.
Frick. Robbie. No, not Henry Winkler. Robbie Damon.
Deuce Bigelow.
From Critical Role. I was at the same party, like, literally, like, 5 feet away from him, and Aaron was like, just go say hi, and I was like, no, I froze. Also,
I listened to her fret about it for 45 minutes.
Abria Iyengar was also, like,
right next to us
at Gen Con.
I could have spit on her,
and he, that's a very weird thing to say,
because that would have been rude.
5 feet away from me. We were at Gen Con, and she was, like, in the aisle, like, 5 feet away.
Super nice.
And I was too nervous to go up. Okay, so here's the thing. I get... Can we not talk about my work? Baby, we're not talking about your work. Okay, so here's the thing. I get real nervous. I have, like, crippling anxiety. I get super freaking nervous when I'm around people that I see as, like, as celebrities. Okay? I don't know why I did this, because they're actual celebrities. I know Iron Tusk, but listen. So, the first time I had that experience, yeah, I get starstruck, like, to the point where it's embarrassing, and, like, that was why when, like, I was right next to Robbie, I was freaking the hell out. I almost said that word. Freaking out, and then I finally told Aaron, let's just go back to the hotel room. And then we just left the party. And I went back to the hotel room, and I got in the shower, and I just cried. Because my body can't handle it. My heart can't handle it. My brain can't handle it. It's just, like, really, really bad. I went to Dragon Con. I think it was my second year at Dragon Con. Went to Dragon Con. I met Eddie McClintock from,
To His Enough.
God damn it. Warehouse 13. And he, like, spoke to me, and I couldn't get any words out. There were zero words that would come out of my mouth. I just started crying. My ex-husband was with me, and so my ex-husband started talking to him and, like, telling him, like, she's just super nervous, but she absolutely loves you. And, like,
she has a condition.
And then I got a picture with him for free, because he felt bad, because we didn't realize you have to have, like, they won't take card for photos, and you have to pay for a photo. And so, like, we didn't have any cash. So he felt bad. And so he just grabbed my phone and then took selfies with me. But, yeah, legit, I freeze up. Dee was super starstruck when we met that dude from Mad Men at a game convention. I have no doubt. I'm glad it's not just me. Like, I freak out. Man, that must have been a good night for Aaron, you meeting Robbie. But I didn't meet him.
Oh, it was horrible, because I quickly told her, just go over there. I'll go over there. And, like, just the fear in her eyes, I was like, okay, I'm not going to go over there.
Yeah, he stopped pushing it, because he could tell that I was going to, like, die.
I mean, I was about to just go punk rock and walk over there and be like, hey, my girlfriend's really nervous about me, and you just come over here. And that probably would have been a bad move.
Yeah.
At that time.
Yeah, I freak out.
But it is too bad, because, like, we were working the Flying Frog booth, and, like, that girl was right there, and she was so nice to everyone.
Yeah.
Like, she was trying to get somewhere, and she got stuck in front of our booth for, like, an hour. And she just stayed there and hung out with people and talked to people, and it was like, okay, well, I guess I'm not going there. Let's do this.
Yeah.
It was really cool.
My friend Michael designed the Warehouse 13 board game and got to work with the Eddie dude. Oh, my gosh, that's so cool.
Eddie Vedder?
No, Eddie McClintock. Oh, my God.
What?
Third time's a charm. You did a great job at Iron Tusk. He was great in the studio. I have no doubt. I'm a big-ass baby. Can't help it.
One of these days, I'm going to trick you into meeting one of those people. Like, you'll get done talking to them and be like, wait a second, was that Eddie Vedder? I'll be like, oh, my God, I think it was.
You're ridiculous.
Yeah, but I would have gotten you to meet that person that you were afraid to meet. It would have been cool. You'd be like, you know what? It wasn't so bad talking to that person.
But,
and then, like, you'll be okay meeting other people that
maybe,
you admire.
Maybe. I don't know. I just freak out so bad. Also, it is 10:15, just FYI.
Man, we got like 8 hours.
Excuse me? We didn't get 8 hours.
This was it's called Up All Night. It was Reverbeck.
Nope,
right?
That is not that's not what this is.
That's not what we said. Okay. Well, I was wrong with that.
I did get starstruck once, but it was a board game designer from Germany, and then we met and drank beers and had a good time. I love that trash.
I realized they were just a person like me. And
Aaron is actually right. Experience makes it easier. You ventured from the dumpster. Hello, Josh.
How's life?
What rock have you been under? Hey, busy's good though. To call it a night, sleep well, all. Have a good night, Heather. Thank you for dropping by, hun.
Hi, Heather.
Appreciate you.
Keep it real. Happy holidays.
Oh, you know what? This whole time I should have been doing this. I forgot that this house of... Is that how it is? Those are our links, by the way. Did you know we had links?
Do we have links?
We have links.
Links.
Crazy.
It's a magical fruit.
Crazy.
I kind of like the orangey-red ground. Oops. Oh. Almost spilled my second pot of GW paint. That would have been awesome.
Please don't spill more.
This is starting to get an expensive stream here.
What's going on with your wet palette there?
It's sliding over. It's really full of water. For once, it's not dried out.
Uh-oh.
Nice, but kind of just moving around with...
You're moving around.
I made it too full, maybe.
Gen Con was fun. I tried to catch Aaron, but didn't see him the 2 seconds I had to leave my booth.
If you came on Sunday, we weren't even there. So that was...
Yeah, if it was Sunday, we weren't... We weren't there. Yeah. Our flight left at like, I don't know, it was early.
It was too early.
I was at Dice Fest 2. Oh, we were there. Josh, we were in the
paint room.
We were in the paint room. Aaron 3D print those Citadel anti-pot spill holders. You should.
I should sculpt my own and print those.
I spent exactly 2 hours in the vendor hall this year. I don't remember how much time we had, but we spent a good amount of time in the vendor hall. I mean, like, well, we worked in the vendor hall, but, like, we got to walk around and stuff. And then we spent, like, $500 on art, so that was super fun.
Yeah, that was the best part.
Ask me how much has been hung up.
One piece.
Two. We have one piece over the board games, and one piece over the DVDs in the living room. Yeah, make your own Iron Joy Industries paint pot holders. You have to give it like a super long name though, Ian. So you gotta like throw in some like
just
random.
Just make it
words.
So difficult for people to even like.
People are gonna be like,
it.
I don't know. They're just, I don't know. One of Jordan's gifts just shipped.
Sweet.
The smaller gift. Quit buying art.
Holy cow.
Bless you. Jesus. We quit buying art because Dee and I fight over getting good frames over cheap ass frames for art. We go cheap.
We go cheap.
Man, we drove as a company to Gen Con. We could only bring so much back with us. Oh, that's super. That's frustrating.
Who is that?
Josh Davis. We, I don't remember. I don't think we bought any, like, board games or anything.
No. At Gen Con?
Yeah.
No, we literally spent our entire budget on art.
On art, yeah. So it was just all in a, we took a tube with us. And then we just put all of the art in the tube.
We're prepared. And that we figured if we lose that tube, it's like this $700 tube.
Well, we took it like that was our one of our carry-ons.
Yeah.
Frames should cost more than the art. Ian, probably sweetie, if you want to buy us frames, go right ahead. We like simple frames,
though. We like them just like black.
Black. Because it doesn't, just black.
Just
thin,
like a plinth. It's got to be black.
Yeah.
Like my soul.
We were on a wait list for a booth, and Gen Con told us we could come 10 days out.
Oh, that was nice of them.
Holy shit.
So luckily your plane flights weren't expensive and all that good
stuff. Well, I think they drove. Yeah, they drove as a company. So that's terrifying. Wow,
that is gnarly.
We have found some amazing frames at hospice stores. Hospice stores. Am I reading that correctly? What's a hospice store? IKEA frames to the rescue. If we were close to IKEA, I would go and buy IKEA frames.
Yep.
But we are 2.5 hours away from IKEA. Actually. We literally live 2.5 hours away from two IKEAs. We
sucks.
Can work out something. Deal, Ian. Deal. Speaking of booths, I saw the booth lottery date passed. Or already passed for the 23. Oh, did it really? When people go into hospice programs, they donate items to the stores to help fund the hospice. I did not realize that. I don't know if we have those here.
We have a dollar store. It's kind of the same thing.
No, it's not. Broken Anvil's office is across from IKEA. It's a terrible temptation.
Oh, God, I would not like that at all. That would be...
Constantly going over to IKEA.
Can we fit another Detoff case in our bathroom?
We need more cases.
We need cases, period. We have nothing to display anything in.
Yeah. Great for finding amazing furniture as well. I bet. Our office is all IKEA stuff.
So the rule with IKEA...
I bet it would be.
If it's solid in the showroom, it'll be solid forever. If it's shaky in the showroom, it'll be shaky forever. So that's how you can tell which is good pieces and bad pieces.
Yep. Boop. Why is this? Only one thing pisses me off in IKEA, the soda. That shit's nasty. I'm gonna be honest, I don't remember the soda. It's been so long since I've actually eaten in an IKEA.
So the first time I ever ate in an IKEA was with you, Liz. I'm pretty sure. Because we're like, well, should we? Sure. And then every time we went there afterwards, we ate there.
Did we?
We did. I mean, it's not like we went to IKEA all that often.
Oh,
but
yeah, no.
We went twice, I think, and we ate there both times.
So when I lived up near Atlanta... my ex and I would go to IKEA, and every time we would go, we would always eat there.
Really?
Yeah, every time.
I'm kind of jealous.
Because Swedish meatballs. Well, babe, you weren't around.
Wait, you're telling me that you were with someone before me?
Right?
What? Mind blown.
We have like 6 of the mega Detoffed cases for all the minis in the office, and I'm terrified to ever move them. Oh my god, I would be too. We need like 2 or 3 Detoffed cases.
So we need 2 or 3 of those, and then they have the double wide ones. Those are the ones I really want because they're a little bit nicer, and they're Well, obviously double
wide.
Well,
we could get like two of those. We don't really have that much space in the house.
No, well, the double wide ones aren't that big either. It's just, yeah, instead of getting like four DTOF cases, we'd get a couple double wides and...
Yeah.
That doesn't really sound right math-wise, but who cares?
Swedish elderberry soda? Ew. That's gross. He said they have the double ones. The issue is you can't get extra shelves for those without buying a whole case. Shady. That's super weird.
I don't think I need extra shelves for the... I mean, mm-mm. It's different for them. They're putting all
their
company's models in there, right? So
yeah, the glass cases. For displaying, like, miniatures and stuff. Man,
yeah.
Taylor's, like, really into Instagram right now. I keep thinking I have notifications on Instagram, and it's Taylor sending both of us videos.
It's like the same but different, you know.
Could just go to a regular hardware store and get glass plates cut to size for added shelving. Oh, that's true. We also do prep work / statues, so we fill up space fast. That makes sense. You can buy the pens for extra shelves on Amazon, and I just measured the glass and had Lowe's cut me shelves. Hey, dude,
yeah,
whatever
that's
works.
That's a definite. I used to work right next to a glass shop. That was awesome. You could literally get anything you wanted. They also did the other stuff, the plexiglass, or not plexiglass, the plastic shelves, which were really good too. If you didn't scratch them or anything, they were perfect.
I'm sitting still for so long.
Hurting for certain. Skulls. It's what's for dinner.
Good to see y'all. Good to see you too, Josh. Thanks for stopping by.
Yeah, doing great work over there, man. I'm not just saying that. I saw some of it.
It's 10:30. Are you like getting to a stopping point where you could maybe finish that up on the 30th?
I'm just getting started. Yeah, I think, I mean, this is looking pretty cool. Like, I guess. I don't know. Maybe it's not.
No, I think it looks really cool. Look at that. So, look how shiny and pretty he is.
It definitely, it's funny what just painting, getting base colors on the base did. For the rest of it, definitely throws you off when it's not.
Some of them around me are called Habitat for Humanity. Gotcha. Yeah, they build houses in our area. Let's just cut the stream so she can watch Yellowstone. I don't watch Yellowstone.
She wants to know two. She wants to see two is enough or whatever. Three is a.
No.
Two is a third.
I want to
look at that show.
I want to go put my pajamas on and take my makeup off, and then maybe play some Guilders 2 with Rich.
All she wants to do is go to bed.
Huh?
Oh, that's what it is. You want to play video games. I get it.
Well, yeah. The Wednesday stuff was added, and I've only done like a little bit.
Whatever. Yeah, I think we can definitely finish this up on the 30th. No problem.
Okay, perfect.
So I'll do the sword.
Yeah.
And we'll do airbrushing and all that. Yada, yada, yada.
Yada, yada, yada. Okay, so that's all of our socials. Did I just? Oh, yes. Go follow us on Instagram and
definitely come back on the
30th. Twitch. On our Twitches.
We'll be doing
Twitch. Good question, Trash. How about let's do Wapple since Aaron's wearing his Wapple shirt. But Aaron's got to switch back over to our face cams before.
Before we
finish
do the
up.
Wobble.
But go follow us on our Twitches and our Instagrams and our Patreon.
Look at that church.
Love you guys.
Peace out, yo.
Look.
Keep it gangster.
Look at that. Man, your hair looks so much better.
Where?
Now that, why is your hat crooked?
I don't know. I wanted to be like Michael Proctor.
Oh, okay.
I know. I don't know.
I don't know either.
Some things happen.
Silly goose. Well, okay, Trash. You get us ready for that raid. Let's go raid some wobbles.
Get it. Got it. Good.
Boop, boop, ba-doo. Thank you guys for joining us tonight.
Yeah, thank you.
We appreciate it. Sorry I wasn't super excited. I don't know what the word is I'm trying to say.
Alive.
Sorry I was like half asleep. We'll just go with that phrase.
I think you were very entertaining the whole show, so.
Because my brain isn't working.
Sometimes I find that that's the best way to live life.
You're not wrong. You are not wrong. So we're letting Trash gear us up for. All
right. We're getting geared up.
Reaper Best Metals. Are you asking for which ones? For the best metals? Nurgle Matthew. I'm going to be completely honest. I can't even think of any off the top of my head. We just grab whatever we can find. And that's what we use. See you later. Thank you for joining us.
And stuff. I don't know when to turn this off, so you're going to have to tell me.
Okay, you can stop stream now.